in olden days, a glimpse of stocking was a looked on as something shocking. But now, God knows, anything goes. Good offers to who once knew better words, now only used for letter words, writing prose. Anything goes.
Many people prefer to go to mass in leisure clothes. They want to be comfortable and think that God would like them to be comfortable. That type of thinking is to make God in our own image. In other words, it's believing in a God that thinks the way that we want him to think. However, there's absolutely nothing in Scripture that suggests God wants us to be comfortable. If any man will come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross and follow me. A priest once asked, "If you were invited to go to supper with the Queen of England, how would you dress?" And he said that you'd probably wear a suit and tie as a sign of respect. Then he asks, "When you are invited to the Lord's Supper with the King of Kings, shouldn't we want to dress at least as nice as we would for the Protestant Queen?" Although God looks to the soul and its dispositions rather than to externals, yet, as the ritual says, those who communicate should approach the altar with humble deportment, and their dress and everything about them should show forth the reverence which they feel for the Blessed Sacrament. The January 9, 1934 edition of the Catholic Advance included this Q&A. Question: is it wrong to go to Mass without a suit coat? Answer: there exist such circumstances that would make it necessary for a man to go to Holy Mass without wearing a coat, and surely that would not be wrong. And surely no priest would tell a poor man to leave the church because he doesn't have a coat to wear. At times there are those who, for the sake of sporting a sweater or merely to act sporty, do not wear a coat. We ought to keep in mind the deep respect we owe to the house of God, to Jesus, and the Blessed Sacrament. The Code of Canon Law of 1917 says, "Men in a church or outside a church, while they are assisting at sacred rites, should be bareheaded unless the approved mores of the people or particular circumstances of such things determine otherwise. Women, however, should have a covered head and be modestly dressed, especially when they approach the table of the Lord." Question: why is it considered to be disrespectful for a lady to be in church with their head uncovered? And why is it just the opposite for men? St. Paul gives a reason in his first epistle to the Corinthians. St. Paul wrote, "Every man praying or prophesying with his head covered disgraces his head, but every woman praying or prophesying with her head not covered disgraces her head. For it is all one as if she were shaven. For if a woman be not covered, let her be shorn. But if it be a shame to a woman to be shorn or to be made bald, let her cover her head. The man indeed ought not to cover his head, because he is the image and glory of God. But the woman is the glory of man. For the man is not of the woman, but the woman is of the man. For the man was not created for the woman, but the woman for the man. Therefore ought the woman to have a power over her head because of the angels." And the Challoner note explains, "A power over her head means a veil or a covering, and that's a sign that she is under the power of her husband, and this, the Apostle says, is because of the angels who are present in the assemblies of the faithful." As an aside, there is no corresponding footnote in the Douay Rheims version of 1582. St. Paul continues, "You yourselves judge. Does it become a woman to pray unto God uncovered? Does even the nature itself teach you that a man indeed, if he nourishes his hair, it's a shame unto him? But if a woman nourishes her hair, it is a glory to her, for her hair is given to her for a covering." The February 17, 1934 edition of the Catholic Advance included this Q&A. Question: is it sinful to wear sleeveless dresses, especially to church? And what about parties and going to town? Answer: let your modesty be known to all men, St. Paul tells us. Whether it is sinful or not to wear sleeveless dresses in each individual case must be decided by your confessor. He will be able to judge. Do not always be concerned with this one question, is it sinful or not? Try to do some positive good. The world needs more modesty, particularly among the young. Of course, the old are not excluded. Well, I hope that you enjoyed this installment. I'll be back again in about a week with another one. But in the meantime, please pray for the church. Clean shirts, new shoes, and I don't know what I am going to do. Silk suits, black tie, and I don't need a reason why.
bottle shocked.